In Easter of 2011, I didn't know how dead my soul really was. In Easter of 2011, I didn't know how dead my soul really was. 9 years ago, I was an arrow, just floating in the wind, no direction, no guidance, no real place to land, no target in sight. And then in college, I met this girl named Ashley. And Ashley was the first Christian I ever met. And there was something about her. She had an energy of joy and kindness and compassion. And that was really attractive to me. And it really caught me off guard because I never met anyone like that. She tried to talk to me about God, but I pushed it away. And I didn't really want to hear about it. I've been to church a couple of times, but I didn't really have a connection with God. And I didn't really think about God at all. I thought it was a myth, or I thought it wasn't for me. She asked me to go to church with her, and I did. And church was so much different than what I thought. There were kind people, and there was, you know, entertaining music and sermons, and it blew my mind how much these people loved each other and had no connection with me, but loved me too. So we're hanging out more, and it's a week before Easter, and we're watching a documentary called The Shroud of Turin. During it, they're talking about Jesus. And I'm asking Ashley, I was like, so Jesus was a real person? And she said, yeah, he was a real person. And there's the Bible, and it talks about what he did, and we know the places where he went. And I'm like, oh. And then things start clicking, where I'm thinking more about, wow, if this is a possibility, this is a big deal. If this guy is real, this changes everything. And then these words just popped into my head that I don't think I've ever heard before, that certainly wasn't part of my vocabulary before. But I turned to Ashley and said, I think I want to serve Jesus. And she was so caught off guard. She said, really? And I said, yeah, I do. I want to serve Jesus. And then she said, okay, let's pray. So she led me in a sinner's prayer where we prayed, and I asked God to forgive me of my sins. And this is the first time I've ever prayed. So we're praying, and I start to feel this heat starting in my belly and raise up and go up and raise up, and almost chokes me at my throat. And then I just burst out crying, just weeping and crying harder than I've ever cried before. And looking back, that was a time when I was releasing all the anger and the frustration and the searching and the longing and never finding anything that really made any sense. And at that moment, that was when the Holy Spirit came in and changed me, and he gave me a new spirit, and he gave me a new hunger, where now my soul isn't dead, but now it's thriving. And now, even though I stumble and I don't think I'm doing well, God has blessed the work of my hands. I have a wife, I have three kids, I have a home. He's my dad, Jesus is my friend, and I'm so glad that I met him. And he's really changed everything. And I really love the life that I have now. In my old life, I feel like it was a dream. And now my new life, God says, wake up. Lewis, wake up. You're alive. My name's Lewis. I'm not perfect, but I'm forgiven, and I'm living proof of God's grace. I feel so alive.